Whether you're an engineer designing energy-efficient buildings, an architect creating sustainable structures, or a developer focused on minimizing carbon emissions, there's one essential tool you need to know about: Building Lifecycle Assessment, or LCA. Curious about what it is, why it's crucial, and how to implement it? Keep watching. Lifecycle Assessment, or LCA, is a scientific method for evaluating the environmental impacts of a product, process, or service throughout its entire lifecycle. This comprehensive approach examines everything from raw material extraction to manufacturing, use, and eventual disposal or recycling. When applied to the construction industry, Building Lifecycle Assessment focuses specifically on evaluating the environmental impacts of a building throughout its entire life. It measures these effects across four key stages. The first one is production and construction. This involves creating and assembling building materials. It covers the stages A1 to A5, and it's where the embodied to upfront carbon is generated. We've made a video about embodied carbon, check it out in the description. The second, which is also the longest stage, is the use phase, and this involves energy consumption, water usage, maintenance, replacements, and other operational activities. The third is the end of life, and this covers the decommissioning and disposal of the building when it's no longer useful. Then we actually have a fourth, and this is called the benefits beyond the system boundary, also called Module D, and this considers the broader effects of a building's lifecycle beyond its direct scope. LCA's strength lies in its ability to unravel complex interaction between a building and its environment and turning them into meaningful metrics. For example, it quantifies global warming potential by assessing 7 major greenhouse gases and expressing them as CO2 equivalent for easy comparison. While global warming potential is often the focus, LCA also considers other impacts like eutrophication, acidification, smog formation, and ozone depletion. And this gives us a comprehensive view of a building's environmental footprint. LCA results are trustworthy because they are based on international standards like the ISO 14040 and 14044, and of course the European standard, the EN15978. This ensures consistency, reliability, and independence from commercial pressure. There are several benefits to performing a building lifecycle assessment, and the most significant one is that it helps you reduce your project's environmental impacts. Doing an LCA early in the design can provide insights to cut embodied carbon before construction even begins. It also can help you earn credits in certification schemes like BREEAM or LEED and comply with whole life carbon and Scope 3 GHG reporting requirements. Additionally, it can help you create cost-efficient benchmarks, improve transparency, and more. And that's a quick introduction to Building Lifecycle Assessment. If you've liked this one, you might also enjoy the video here. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. See you then.